This guy is not the owner of the channel I am actually addressing here. Turns out he's merely a guest on this channel, being interviewed. And I had a look at Howard's channel itself, and it's mostly just being a very annoying flurf on the street talking about his horse shit, which is basically non-content. So this interview was rather interesting because he is answering some questions, making my job a lot easier. Also, I'm cutting out the entire introduction of this video because it is annoyingly loud in terms of music. And to be quite honest, nothing really happens. There's just people walking around being filmed, and he does have a banner though. Dare I say, spanner banner. But yeah, let's first have him introduce himself. Mind you, I will tell you his name is indeed Howard George Stirrup, in case you are unable to catch it with the really weird cut they did with the music. So here goes.
Hello, I'm Howard George Stirrup. I'm here in Edinburgh with John Smith from the Globe Lie, doing some activism to expose all the bullshit that we've been programmed with since we were 4 or 5 years old.
Ah yes, bullshit. I do believe the official term is horseshit. Also, you gotta love the conspiracy theorist mindset, eh? So first of all, let's have a look at this fancy banner you have. Mind you, I photoshopped it into this, which is a Photoshop composite. So I actually have a banner I can read in its entirety, instead of you panning along and people walking in front of it. So here goes. Let's utterly destroy your fancy flat earth talking points, as we always do. We were told we were living on a ball earth when we were infants, when we were young, impressionable, and naive, before our critical thinking skills had developed. Now of course you have to paint that doomsday scenario, don't ya? You gotta feed that flat earth narrative, somehow. So I will be jumping back and forth between this banner and this other horseshit so it doesn't get stale. Also, I basically had to edit his video audio because he is playing some kind of music in the background, which really sounds like some copyrighted stuff. I've already seen some copyright claims on his video, so I'm not gonna risk that. But hey, this stuff is not gonna save you from the likes of me. I just remove your music and leave your voiceover for the most part. Not to mention your music was basically double echoing or something, so I probably did people a favor listening to this crap. Just think of it like an old school radio.
To be fair, like most of us, I heard about it, I shrugged it off, laughed about it for a month or two, and then I ended up sitting down in the mood and watching 200 Proofs and a few other movies.
Oh boy, the 200 Proofs by Eric Dubé, eh? I'm left wondering how that guy even gets subs. I mean, he is so boring to listen to. Not to mention all those so-called proofs are utter horseshit, all of which have been refuted, and most of them are actually duplicates of previous ones. So it doesn't even add up to 200. What? A fleur flying? How is that possible?
Don't you think that science should be demonstrable, repeatable, and verifiable?
Exactly. And everything which proves the Earth is a sphere is demonstrable, repeatable, and verifiable. It is very telling that the Flat Earth movement has nothing. They don't have demonstrable, repeatable, and verifiable evidence. Not to mention you guys can't even falsify the current standing models.
Yet gravity holding vast oceans flowing around a ball has never been proven. All water has to be contained.
You're living in your own experiment there. And the water is contained by gravity. And you can whine all you want that gravity is not a thing. You have to prove it's not a thing because we do have an acceleration of objects towards the planet of 9.8 meters per second squared.
And I was pretty convinced within the first 5 proofs that they were on for something, and the more I looked into it, the more I was certain that we're being lied to.
Well, that basically sums up your research. If you think the first 5 of those are already proof that the Earth is flat or we're being lied to, I've got some news for you, buddy. You've been lied to! And I'll leave it up in the air for you to figure out who has lied to you.
Then I started doing my own experiments, probably a few weeks after that. And then I went public instantly. As most people, I started with a bit of online activism, just on Facebook, by sharing videos that woke me up with my friends and family.
Yes, quite. That's how all your flirts start. By a complete lack of understanding, pure ignorance, sometimes even willful ignorance, because you want to believe the Earth is flat, and then you also harass your friends and family. So tell me, how did that work out for you?
And mostly just got ridiculed.
Oh, as well you should. Now if only you stopped being a flurf, you wouldn't be ridiculed now, would ya? You gotta get those victim points in. And trust me, your friends and family were just looking out for you, but hell, you went down the rabbit hole.
So then my next step was offering €1,000 for evidence of half of the supposed curvature, 4 inches from R squared.
Well, that sums about up your understanding of how science works. First of all, the 8 inches per mile squared, that ends up with a parabola, meaning it will only work on a local scale. And second of all, why would you ask for half the... that doesn't even make sense. Like I said, it does actually sum up your understanding of how science works. You just gotta eyeball it, man. Who the hell cares if the values are accurate or not?
Again, got ridiculed, so I upped to 10,000 when I threw a television crew in my local market where I work. And that really went well. I went viral in Spain on television, and then it got mirrored onto the channels that helped me get really popular in South America. Well, not me, the competition, or should I say the offer. And it's been about a year and a half to 2 years now. No one's been able to send me evidence, obviously.
Mm-hmm. So viral is not the word you're looking for, because if you went viral, you would have been gaining a lot more subs and views for that. And as it stands right now, your channel has around 46k views, 631 subs, and 95 videos. Not to mention, I've seen plenty of comments on your videos claiming that $10,000. They have proven your Earth is indeed curving. You're just ignoring them, so what gives? There's something obviously going on here, and it's not the lack of evidence on their part. The moon landings were a hoax. Yes, and just saying things is not enough. You have to prove it, and it has never been proven. I mean, if the moon landing was a hoax, why didn't the Russians call America out on their so-called horseshit? They would have been literally the first in line to do that.
It's quite easy to get people to realize they've been lied to by recommending they do the experiments for themselves rather than what a lot of these people are doing by promoting a model of flat Earth or recommending they go and watch secondary information like other people's videos.
And that is, of course, all fine and dandy. The only problem here is that you guys do research and don't do it properly. You try and lead the evidence where you want to go, which is a flat pancake. And as soon as you encounter any form of counter evidence to your claims, it is instantly dismissed out of hand. You gotta cherry pick the evidence. Oh, and by the way, here's a fun fact. A pancake is actually less flat than the Earth locally, even in mountainous terrain. That's mostly because the mountains are tiny compared to the Earth. Images of Earths are photoshopped. Or rather, it's photoshopped because it has to be. I am getting sick and tired of this one, by the way. A composite is not a hoax. It's just images stitched together. It's a panorama of the bloody Earth. Stop using this. Really, stop using this. It only makes you look stupid. Well, being a flurf makes you look stupid as well, so well done, I guess. Also, I just photoshopped your banner together. Does that make your banner fake? So, using your own logic, your banner is fake. See how stupid that is?
We're not asking people to believe. We're telling them to do it themselves and to know with personal experience, first-hand observations.
Well, we're gonna go back to basic flurfing. Personal experience, that is actually a new one. It's usually personal observations using your own natural senses instead of actually relying on accurate equipment. I mean, there's actually a reason why we use a solar filter, for example, to see the shape of the sun. Good luck with your natural senses to try and don't look at the sun. Flat Earth, is it becoming static or is it growing?
No, no, it's getting easier. I've seen people opening up, even if they don't realise that they're hearing about it on mainstream media that might be ridiculing us, but the seeds are dropping and it's been around now for a while, so people are starting to think, well, if there was nothing to it, it would have been done and dusted already, so keep it coming.
Oh, definitely, keep it coming. But here's another... it's actually quite ironic. You think that the size of a group actually has any meaning. Instead of accepting you have been proven wrong time and time again, you just dig down and try to hide behind some kind of ridicule thing. More victim mentality. Good job there. Neil Armstrong presented a fake moon rock to the Dutch government, which is in fact a well-known thing. So where's the conspiracy? The American government has acknowledged this and also has apologized for it. What's the most challenging part of street activism?
I guess it's the same for everybody. The ridicule, you know, especially when it's from friends and family. And you know, you're trying your best to help people and all they want to do is shut you down and censor you, you know. But on the bright side, the more people ridicule and are ignorant, the more you research and the more you improve your arguments. So I'm finding that I'm getting better at answering these arrogant comments, and I'm finding that I'm getting joy from learning more.
Yeah, right. More victim mentality. They are trying to censor you. How are they trying to censor you? I mean, you're walking on the street right now, talking about your utter horseshit. Not to mention it's being recorded and sent to the tubes. I'm watching this video right now. I downloaded it from the tubes. So where's this censoring? Or do you actually believe that someone who is disagreeing with you is censoring you? That's not how censoring works, buddy. Not to mention learning how to debate your points, even if your points are demonstrably wrong. That's not progress. That's actually quite the opposite of progress there. I mean, your banner here says everything about what you think. Passenger planes cannot fly level round a ball. Planes continuously flying level would shoot off into space. Uh-huh. And how exactly would they do that with their ever-decreasing density of the air? First of all, they wouldn't be able to provide enough lift, and second of all, the engines would basically stall because of the lack of oxygen. Don't you think it's great to see more people becoming involved in street activism?
I think it's great that everyone's got their own flavor to add to, because all types of people. Some people wake up to the funny memes, some people need a bit more serious content. You couldn't exclude anything, because at the end of the day we're trying to raise awareness to as many people as possible. So I think everyone out there, just do your own thing and just learn from other people and, you know, apply it in your own fashion, what you're comfortable with.
Well, you know, back in the day we had circuses which were also having freak shows. The floors are basically our current freaks. People like to look at them, point at them, laugh at them. But here's the thing, back in the day we actually forced certain people with disabilities to actually go into these circuses, exploiting them for all their worth, which was quite a wrong thing to do. Yet now we have flurfs who are voluntarily being a freak. So, stop being a victim. You call this on yourself. You don't have any arguments, you don't have any substantiation to any of your claims, you actually claim you don't make any claims. And you're left wondering why we make fun of you. You are here for our entertainment. So, either stop being a flurf, come back to reality, or continue and get made fun of. Pilots do not dip the aircraft to compensate for the alleged curve of the Earth. So, you know, level is in relation to the center of the planet. It's not in relation to the... Level and flat are not the same thing, dick flute. Not to mention, how small do you think our planet is? This is another scale issue. You guys never understand scale. Why do you think so many people are resistant to the thought of the globe being a lie?
Pride. See, we've all been indoctrinated with an education system that promotes memorizing secondary information. So now that people that are not as educated with PhDs and, you know, university degrees comes up to his friends and says, hey guys, we're being lied to. It's like a shock to their pride that someone could dare question all the stuff that they've memorized, where really we should be educated to question and inquire and understand and interpret something ourselves with evidence, not just memorization and people that are supposed to be even cleverer than us.
Yes, quite. So you don't understand how the education system works. In terms of physics and math in this case, you have to memorize the certain formulas to actually be able to apply them. And when you apply them, you are also able to understand them. Just because you don't understand these equations and make a claim from ignorance, and then actually try to apply evidence being researched by people who have no idea what they're talking about. Is something adding up there? I'm sure nothing is adding up in your head, because you apparently don't understand any of that. Tell me, would you hire a butcher to fix your car? Pretty sure he's gonna butcher your engine. And how did you manage to add another victim point in there? Is that basically all you're about? This is so stupid. This is so stupid! What do you think is going to happen over the next couple of years with this subject matter?
Well, that depends on us, doesn't it? This is why we're here promoting activism. Because this human race isn't going to win the race if we all just sit back and get entertained by the new famous celebrities of the Flat Earth movement that are just promoting each other's channels and having conferences to pat each other on the back. I'm sorry, guys, but we need to promote activism and spread the word to people that haven't heard about it already, or that are doubting, or that are even against us online and offline. We've got to raise awareness.
The human race isn't gonna win the race. No, I'll do the crappy jokes around here, Howard. Also, the insane infighting of the Flat Earth community begs to differ here. There are various groups of these so-called famous flurfs who are constantly at each other's throats. They're quite toxic. Most of them unable to have a proper conversation. It's usually just yelling and evasion, which we, in the business, call dumpster fires. And while entertaining, they also are completely fruitless. So, promoting each other? Those are not the words you're looking for. And that's not even mentioning that the Flat Earth community hasn't accomplished anything in the last years. Their brain farts started infecting the tubes. Let alone the last millennia, when it was utterly disproved. You lot are always trying to make it sound like this crap is some kind of recent thing. Now, if you lot would stop lying, you'd no longer be a flurf. Earth's curvature is not visible. The horizon is always flat, no matter your height. Well, well, well. The Earth's curvature is indeed not visible when you're standing on the beach, for example. Unless you actually rise in altitude. Then it starts to curve, which has been demonstrated time and time again to you lot. Ignoring it doesn't make the facts go away, but hey, flurf's gonna flurf. I am rather surprised you didn't actually add the horizon is always at eye level, which is also easily demonstrated to be false. Horizon altitude, the horizon drops. But then again, eye level is not the same as level. Eye level is basically the thing you're looking at, whereas actual level is in relation to the horizon. And this only goes for the horizontal curve. It's quite interesting you're not mentioning the boats going over the horizon, bottom first. Or the bottom of buildings being cut off, or even entire freaking mountains. Perspective does not explain the bottoms being cut off, no matter how much you wish for it, flurf. What's been your biggest learning curve?
Still learning how to handle my emotions, because even though we're facing programmed responses, it is hard not to take some of them personal. But yeah, practice makes it perfect, and I've really enjoyed it overall. It's a learning process, and I feel like I'm advancing with my social skills and obviously my education. I'm learning so much. It's great. I really wouldn't change it for the world.
Well, that was a missed opportunity for making a curve joke there. Learning curve, eh? Also, this smile of yours is just a facade. I have seen the toxic little man behind your mask as well. In a few of your videos, when people don't actually agree with you, you start to lose your shit. Which is, of course, expected from a flurf. You're a grown-ass man, still working on your social skills. Something seems off there. And somehow you managed to throw in another victim point. I have no words for that one. Other than, I'll be right back. With the globe being a lie, what's your main focus? Let me guess, dipshittery.
I'd say exposing lies and showing secrecy for what it is. All secrets are dirty. We've kind of been initiated to believe that self-enlightenment is the way forward. And I think we should all realize we're all on the same plane.
Well, the only horseshit I have to address here is you will never be satisfied. Meaning, you are so goddamn close-minded, you will never accept the Earth being a globe. And that's the thing. You flurfs are set out to make the Earth flat, when in fact it's not. Every time you have been presented with proper evidence, unrefutable evidence to be exact, you just blow it off as it being lies, you know, the globe lie. And you wonder why we make fun of you. Well, holy hell, buddy, you didn't even add a victim card this time. Good job there, Howard. You want a sticker? Are your thoughts your own? Do you have a belief or a knowing? If you weren't told you live on a ball, would you believe you did? The moment to believe something is the moment you prove it. The globe has been proven. And also, are your thoughts your own? What the hell does that even mean? Do you believe there's some kind of thought control machine? Talk about science fiction. So, yeah, my advice, burn that banner because it is utter horseshit. Stop making a fool of yourself. Stop being a flurf. Would be step number one. Rajika, what the hell did you do? Well, I guess it seems, fitting? I don't know. Anyway, Howard George Stirrup.
I sentence you to be a jester in the Order of the Sillies. Leave your banner at the door. As for you, spiffies, I mean you've made it this far into the video. Might as well tickle the bell, smash the subscribe and like button, leave me a comment of what you think, and of course check out all the links in the description. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Oh no, he has a banner. Maybe he actually has a point. No, he doesn't. Dick flutes never do.